foremost of theatrical geniuses, producer of some of the greatest works on the street of white lights, Max Gordon speaks of his co-worker and friend who contributed so much to the American theater, Max Gordon.
Almost at the beginning of his career, I met George Gershwin. I was attracted by a song called Poppyland, then being played in a revue on Top of the Century Theater. I asked the name of the composer and was told it was written by a newcomer, George Gershwin. By a coincidence, I met him on a train a few days later when he was preparing the score for La La Lucille, a new musical piece. He played the music for me some weeks later, and I immediately felt that a new great talent had arrived. He, if anyone, has succeeded in capturing musically the movement, tempo, and excitement of America since the turn of the century. As Stephen Foster immortalized the folk song of the Civil War era, George Gershwin has equally immortalized the folk song of today, and he will live with the immortals where he rightfully belongs. It was Robert Burns, the poet, who said, "An honest man is the noblest work of God." George Gershwin was noble, and he gave the world an honest measure of his musical talents.